Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started doing the things you used to do. As I was motivating over the hill, I saw Maybelline in a coupe ville. A Cadillac rolling on an open road, nothing out run my V8 4. A Cadillac doing about 95, moves bumper to bumper, rolling side to side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the things you used to do. A Cadillac pulled up to 104, my phone got hot and wouldn't do no more. The gun got cloud and started to rain. I tooted my horn for the passing lane. A rainwater blowing all under my hood. I knew that was doing my motor good. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the thing you used to do. Sound. Cadillac setting like a ton of lead, 110 a half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like it's setting still, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the thing you used to do.
My pappy said, son, you're going to drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln. Have you heard the story of the hot rod race when the Fords and the Lincolns were setting the pace? That story is true, I'm here to say, because I was driving that Model A. Got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up, and that Model A body makes it look like a pup. It's got 8 cylinders and use them all. Got overdrive, just won't stall. With 4 bow carbs and a dual exhaust and 411 gears, you can really get lost. Got safety tubes, but I ain't scared. The brakes are good, the tires fair. Pulled out of San Pedro late one night, and the moon and the stars were shining bright. We was driving up old Grapevine Hill, passing cars like they were standing still. All of a sudden, in a wink of an eye, a Cadillac sedan passed us by. I said, boys, that's a mark from me. By then, the taillight was all you could see. Now, the fellas all ribbed me for being behind, so I thought I'd make that Lincoln unwind. Took my foot off the gas, and man alive, I shoved it on down into overdrive. Well, I wound it up to 110. My speedometer said that I'd hit top end. My foot was glued like lead to the floor. That's all there is. There ain't no more. Now the boys all thought that I'd lost my sense, and them telephone poles looked like a picket fence. They said, slow down, I see spots, the lines on the road just look like dots. We took a corner, sideswiped the truck, and I crossed my fingers just for luck. My fenders was clicking the guardrail post, and the guy beside me was white as a ghost. Smoke was coming from out of the back when I started to gain on a Cadillac. I knew I could catch him and I thought I could pass. Don't you know by then we'd be low on gas. I had flames coming from out of the side. You can feel the tension, man, what a ride. I said, look out, boys, I got a license to fly. And that caddy pulled over and let us by. Now all of a sudden she started to knock it down. In the dip she started to rock. And I looked in the mirror, red light was blinking. The cops was after my hot rod Lincoln. Well, they arrested me and they put me in jail, and they called my pappy to throw my bail. And he said, son, you're gonna drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln.
Certified beauty, and I thought it was my patriotic duty to teach her things like necking, yeah, and driving an automobile. Now Charlene McKenzie, while prettier than most, turned out to be as deaf as a post, a condition I was not aware of until she got behind the steering wheel. I had a 57 Chevy, it was born to run. It was a red hot fuel injected son of a gun. And when she showered down on that accelerator, she just froze when it let out a roar. I said, don't rev it so much, take your foot off the gas. She thought I said, pop the clutch and make it go fast. And she did, and friends, we laid rubber for a block or more. And there were chickens on the bumper, yeah, feathers in the grill, rose bushes in the wheel wells, and a pig on my windshield. Yeah, and the bees were a-buzzing where she mowed down there behind. On the day I tried to teach Charlene McKenzie how to drive, I said, hold on a second, I want to talk to you. She thought I said, go for a second and see what she'll do. And we laid more rubber. She jumped to 204. Now Clarkdale, Georgia's just a little old town, and shoot, I thought I knew my way around. But she took me places that day I'd never seen before. Through farms and gullies and over hills, we uncovered lovers and moonshine stills, and broke into a clearing of the annual picnic of the Georgia Highway Patrol. Yeah, we broke up that picnic and everything in it, and those officers were on us in a New York minute. And I knew somehow I just had to regain control, because now there were lovers on the bumper, picnic baskets in the grill. Yeah, wrapped around the fenders was what was left of a moonshine still. There was a wounded patrolman on my windshield yelling, you get free to fire. On the day I tried to teach Charlene McKenzie how to drive. Well,